change in your life. Make it for the better. Now don't you wait no longer. Just set your back farther. It's not for the black and white. It's not for the yellow and red. It's not for the sick and homeless. It's not for just one race. It's not for one generation. I see the whole damn nation.
Special Mardi Gras edition of Off the Grid. A lot of you have been asking about wanting to see the camper. Mardi Gras, actually it's Lundi Gras, but rather than work on the RV, I did a little work on the Teardrop, but I decided to go ahead and take in a couple of parades. And one in particular is the ENDYMION parade. I was able to catch it in New Orleans, and I'll show some video of that later on. Now the plan was to wait till I completely finished the camper before showing it. I wanted to have it set up at the campground and everything before I took you on a tour, but people have asked, I get my inspiration from pictures and things off the internet, and I'll incorporate into my design. So I'll go ahead and do a quick and rough tour of it. This is one side, got my window in it. And I have a shore power connection under here. And I use what's called an electrician's suicide cord. It has male prongs on each end. I don't really recommend encouraging anyone to do something like it. You got to know what you're doing when you make a suicide cord, but it works for me. I use it on a few times that I connect shore power. This is the back part. As you can see, I got my battery box. That's one of the most recent things I did to it. It slides out. This is the rear of it. I have my hatch open. One of the most recent additions I've done is added my 12 volt batteries. Now they're not deep cycle batteries, but I think these two high CCA car batteries work just fine, and they're a lot less expensive than a deep cycle battery, which this will work fine for me. I have it connected to this 1500 3000 watt peak inverter, and got my 12 volt running to my panel inside. Got my little charger, the 10 amp charger, and everything goes is on drawer slides, 100 pound drawer slides, and slides in. There's no handle on the outside. It bolts from the inside to deter theft. This is the back counter. My stargazer window, and you can see I got that idea from a picture I saw on the internet. The back counter, instead of having a wall on the galley, I do have a wall right here. It's got my little fold out table on my junk that I'm still working on. But one thing I did not see on the internet that I really wanted to do is, instead of a wall, I have this swivel. It's a Lazy Susan type, and I'm gonna put my TV on it. I'm gonna mount my TV to it, and right now it would be facing the inside, to where if I was to watch TV from the inside. And if I wanted to watch television from say the campground of the campfire or on side outside, say watch the game or something. I just flip it around and I can watch TV outside. Great way to enjoy a game while you're out in the woods. This is the door. That's the slide out. It's not really a slide out yet. It's just a panel that I got held up there. I hadn't worked on the slide out yet. Have my my composting toilet, which is basically a litter box. I looked online and seen where they use wood shavings or peat moss or something for the dry part of a composting toilet. And some people have used kitty litter, and you just put some like carpet fresh in it or something. And just as long as you keep the solids and the liquids separate, it'll do just fine. You just use the litter box, and it goes in a bag. In this 5-gallon bucket, and it'll be a bag in there, and very low risk of smell, or at least that's the plan. I haven't tested it yet, just yet. Now this is maybe a little tough to see. That's where the batteries slide in. What holds them in? I hope you'll be able to see this. Is I got two slide bolts that will hold it in place, keep it from sliding out. The composting toilet will slide into this little hole, and the inverter will use this cord to connect to the outlet right there on the wall that this dorm refrigerator is plugged into, and therefore powering the entire system. I have two other outlets. I have the one outside outlet. I have an outlet right here on my counter for cooking or whatever. I have one up front at the center of the bed, and there's going to be one on the outside of that wall, because I'm going to cut a hole right below that shelf, and that's where I'm going to put a 5000 BTU air conditioner. I haven't done that yet also. That's the inside. That will be the slide out. Right now it's just a panel being held up, but it'll slide out about 18 inches because my drawer slides are a heavy duty 22 or 24 inch drawer slides. So it'll not a bed. It's not that high. It's just I use couch cushions and from an old couch. Great. It's about a 6-inch foam, and I just got them stacked up. The whole bed frame slides out, and then that makes into a queen size bed. This is the front. It's part of it that I'm still working on. It's going to be a cabinet. V-shaped cabinet by the tongue of the trailer. You see it a lot better this way. I'll put my propane bottle, as you can see where this one is. Then I'll have the generator behind it. And I'll have a shelf about midways, and the little 5000 BTU unit will go right here. I have to cut the hole for this, and it'll go right here. Have the back closed. As you can see my stargazer window. The hinge is four 10-inch or 12-inch stainless piano hinges. And the gasket that keeps everything dry and keeps water from getting in here. This is basically a bicycle tube. I just cut it lengthways. And I've had it outside, out from under this carport in the pouring rain and got in. Nothing gets in. It works very good. And if it cracks or dry rots, well, I just simply take it off and replace it with another bicycle tube. But when I started on it back in September, the trailer was a 6 foot wide by 8 foot trailer that I hauled my motorcycle on, and I used to pull around a 30 foot Gulf Stream, and I had a hitch on the back of the Gulf Stream. And I put I pulled the trailer on that hitch. Due to financial and everything, I got rid of the Gulf Stream, and I decided to. And I still like camping, so I got the trailer. Was in the backyard, covered in weeds and all grown up. Had wood stacked on it, and. So I started with that, and that's what everything is mounted on. And you can see how how it's progressed. The construction has progressed. Okay, so let's. That was a quick and rough tour. Should look better when we get it out, find some BLM land. There's quite a few in Mississippi that I've already got planned out, just waiting on to finish this. Our weather down here is roughly 70s. Every day we've had some cold spells, but so we don't really have a winter to speak of. So we can camp year round. A lot of you northern boondockers, or they call them snowbirds, as they come down here while everything's iced over up north. In my last episode, I was working on a Freon tank barbecue pit, a little miniature barbecue pit, and I did finish it. I haven't used it yet, but it'll certainly be a part of my arsenal in this little teardrop. I didn't do much work the last couple of days on it. It's Mardi Gras season here in Louisiana. I caught a few parades here in the area. I did manage to get down to New Orleans and catch the ENDYMION parade. And we'll go ahead and show you some video of that right now. I'm not commenting or anything. It was just so loud, so I just videoed. Enjoy. See you next time. Yeah.
my friends, I believe we are at the wrong fight. And I cannot read what I did not write. I've been to his house, oh, but the master is gone. But I'd like to leave some things behind.